Alright, this is a good hand. I would not mulligan this one. No Ancestral Visions turn one. Ooh, Detention Spheres. Nice. Yeah, I guess I gotta keep this. Since this leads me to casting Jace on turn four, which I like. Nozomi Shortfang. That's mildly annoying. Gonna have to Detention Sphere that, I think. Probably discarding a Plains here. Yeah, that should be fine. I like my cards in hand. Alright, get out of here, Plains. At least I didn't get Duressed. That would be even worse. Hopefully I'm not getting Force Spiked here. Oh jeez, am I? That would be quite impressive. I'm dazed. Alright, still annoying. Not quite as bad as Force Spike, but still pretty bad. Alright, getting Short Fanged. Let's discard a Sakashima Student since I can't cast it. I'm probably going to discard Angel at some point. Alright, that's minus Jace. Alright, I'm going to take the pile of two no matter what, I think. Probably has to be Lingering Souls by itself. No, Jitte by itself. Yeah, Jitte by itself. I'm still going to take the pile of two since if I don't, I have no creatures to put Jitte on. Alright, this puts me pretty far ahead of the Short Fang, I think. Yeah, my opponent gets to use Short Fang on me, but is wasting lots of mana. And Jace does outrace the Short Fang fairly nicely. Of course, took out Supreme Verdict, which is unfortunate. Let's see, what do I do here? Probably cast Seer of Visions. Would like to hit a land drop. Alright. Definitely putting one on top, but one on bottom. And casting Lingering Souls, and then plussing Jace. Well, don't love this position. Opponent's now drawing two cards a turn. This puts me pretty firmly behind. Short Fang is an annoying card, so maybe Supreme Verdict is something I want. I think I do want Angel still, so I'm trying to think what I could cut from this. Alright, chumping with a Spirit Token. Drawing a Plains next turn. What are we even casting next turn? Could be Jacing. Probably discarding Miscalculation if I get Short Fanged here. Alright. And it could just be Mold Driftering. Yeah, Mold Driftering sounds fairly good. Let's see what my opponent plays here. Phantasmal Image on Graveborn Muse. Jeez, that's some stuff. And my Detention Sphere's all gone. Alright, plus one Jace, cast Mold Drifter. And pass the turn. Alright, so opponent draws four cards here. Alright. Well, this is something. At least I do a swamp so I can cast Lingering Souls. And Angel's Frenzy is probably the kind of card I'm going to need to get out of this. So if I'm forced to discard, I guess I discard Hinder. And then that lets me Vendilion Click with Force of Will. And then hopefully draw off Jace and whatnot. Though I guess I could double block a Graveborn Muse this turn. That's probably decent. Yes, puts Jace to one. I think that's okay. Alright, let's kill the real one since the other one dies as soon as it's targeted. Alright, trade a Mold Drifter for a Graveborn Muse. Generally a favorable trade. But my opponent's already drawn so many cards that I can't say I'm very happy about what's going on here. Thran Dynamo. I actually think I Force of Will that. It might seem a little bit odd, but I feel like right, with seven cards in hand, my opponent's got to be able to just play two cards a turn, three cards a turn off the Dynamo. Even I can't hope to counter all my opponent's spells, but this actually cuts them off of playing too much stuff. That's actually a pretty nice one. So let's play. Definitely playing a land. Play Tamiyo. Hopefully this resolves. Kill the Graveborn Muse. And plus one the Jace. And then slay with the Spirit Token since the Short Fang doesn't do much. Alright, hopefully don't get a Liliana here. Also, my opponent conveniently didn't get to Short Fang because I assume Dynamo is going to resolve and cast a double blue card, I guess. Maybe a Jace Memory Adept or something like that. Maybe should have left Sunken Ruins Island open. Yeah, I mean, Despite the fact that my opponent did get cast Opportunity in the middle of the game with two Greenboard Muses, I actually don't think I'm in horrendous shape. Alright, discarding Vendilion since I would like to cast Angel. Probably just removing a bunch of cards from my graveyard, actually. Might get my last card Liliana'd here. I'm prepared for that eventuality, though. I mean, this again, I still have two Planeswalkers in play against my opponent's none, so that's decent. I still have a Lingering Souls ready to be flashed back. I'm still probably going to draw something awesome. If I had a shuffle effect, I could get Jite back in the mix, but unfortunately, I did not. Alright. Just the Liliana to get my last card, because that would make sense. No, Time Warp. Well, Time Warp was very good here. Time Warp's a good card with multiple Lilianas and Short Fang and whatnot. Short Fang is now flipped, which at least means I don't have to worry about it anymore. Since now it turns into 3-3 the rack. So yeah, Time Warp does some good stuff with repeated activated abilities and all that, but last game was not the most impressive. I wouldn't mind a Time Walk here. Alright, what do we got? What's the big one here? Black Sun Zenith? No, that wouldn't really make a whole lot of sense. A Liliana? If this is a Liliana, it's almost like the Time Walk did the same thing, so I guess Liliana minus two get a creature isn't too bad. Tamiya's ready to start locking down Stab Whisker there. Glindalin Archmage. Okay, that's not a bad one. Alright, I take three. Sweet draw, dude. Let's see. Let's flash back Lingering Souls. Or try to. Alright, Lingering Souls is a successfully flashbacked. Let's tap down Stab Whisker the Odious. And plus one Jace. I think I've got to get more value here. So I'm going to plus one Jace so I can keep it around. I can block Archmage with some tokens. Can't really get attacked. I've got a disenchant at the ready. maybe I should take out the disenchant back for the Supreme Verdict. What is this? It looks like big Liliana time. No, this is even bigger than that. Kakusho. Alright. I do have a Tamiyo ready to go. I think I want an ultimate Tamiyo this game. I think that would be acceptable. Alright, so I take two off Stab Whisker. Draw. It's minus Jace. Pick up a Kaiga. Yep, I will take Kaiga. Thank you very much. Let's play Kaiga. I'm not too worried about the Force Spike. It would be very unfortunate if my opponent had Force Spike exactly, but with Stab Whisker out, I don't think I can afford to do anything else. Tap down Kakusho, pass the turn. So what happens when Tamiyo goes ultimate? I don't know, I cast a bunch of sweet stuff. I mean, I can't cast very many spells into Glenelund Archmage, so it's pretty lucky hitting Kaiga, since Kaiga's one of the better ones, sure. And Stab Whisker is not going to kill me. I took my Disenchant card, which I may or may not be sighting out shortly. Bad River. Wow, my opponent drew a million cards, but I think I might actually be in okay shape. Alright, let's see. What is this? What's up next here? A Morph. Interesting. Silent Spectre, Bane of the Living. It can't be Willbender since I've got that one. I'm going to take two, go to 12. Plus one that. Plus one Jace. I actually think I get in there with the Kaiga. I'm not too worried about my Kaiga dying. That would be acceptable. And I get to play Blade Splicer here end of turn. I think, or after attacks. I guess I do have to worry about Kaiga plus, or Kakusho plus Stab Whisker maybe eventually killing me, but for now I think I'm going to keep playing good cards as I draw them. Ooh, Vesuvian Shapeshifter. That's what that could be. Well, that still doesn't quite kill me. Since, unlike the olden days, you can only sack one Kakusho to that trigger, so that puts me to 7, Stab Whisker puts me to 5, and then that's about it. I Do have to watch out though. I should probably not play too many more spells. Oh, I might get encountered here. Cryptic Command, Bouncing Tamiyo. Well, Cryptic Command is going to be bad for me no matter what. So, there are a lot of worlds where that just kills me too off casting it and tapping on my creatures. Alright, now this game is looking a lot less good now, but still not over. I mean, the Glenlyndra was annoying, so what could that morph be? It hasn't done anything thus far. It might attack this turn, but if it does, what do I do? Yeah, Cryptic into Duress was pretty nice. Alright. I'm being attacked by this morph. So, if I block with these two and it flips up into a shapeshifter, that's pretty bad. If I don't block and it flips up into a shapeshifter, it's kind of bad. I'm just going to take it, I think. I feel like even if it's shapeshifter... Alright, look like it is not. It is the Silent Spectre. Alright. I take three and discard an island. Might have to sacrifice Jace to the greater good here. We'll see what I draw. So I don't get stabbed to death. Alright, taking the pile of two. And... I guess I can just pass? I don't love it, but if I have Kaiga, then my opponent can't attack me and I'm at much lower life, so... I think passing is the play. I have a lot less Planeswalkers than I did a turn ago. That is unfortunate. Angel's Serenity is gone. No Exalted Angel left. Vendilion Click's gone. Momentary Blink. I think I sided that one out. Well, we'll see. Liliana, not great for me now. Alright, discarding. Getting stabbed. Opponent still has a counterspell sitting on the board. It's not great for me. Ooh, Augur of Bolas. Alright, what can I hit here? So there are some cards. Momentary Blink doesn't do as much here, but I'm going to put this in my hand. Put those in my graveyard. Let's cast Deep Analysis on myself. Alright, and... I guess I can attack Liliana. And then what happens? I get attacked back by the two big things. Yeah, I'll pass, I think. I think the fact that I'm now drawing a bunch of extra cards and I have an Oblivion Ring does mean I should just pass there. So I've already used Attention Sphere. GTA is 7 cards down. 6, 9, 10, 11. No, GTA is more than that since I jaced a few times. So I actually could be drawing GTA fairly soon here. Alright, so not getting stabbed. Hooray. Celestial Vision's not great. Alright. Time to Deep Analysis. Bam. And there's the GTA. So, let's play Oblivion Ring. I assume that's going to get Glenlyndra'd. Since it's pretty hard for that not to. Land, play GTA, pass the turn. Two, I get to discard Ancestral Vision now. That puts me to one. But then I can Courtesard next turn. And then now I'll have GTA up. I have to make sure Kakusha doesn't die, but I can attack with Spirit Tokens and Augurs of Bolas to get my counters up. This is minus 8, so I actually probably got to do something about Liliana, because that gets back Angel Serenity and a million other creatures. So yeah, I guess I have to send some Spirit Tokens and an Augur at Liliana, something like that. I don't know if this all works out, but we'll find out very shortly. Let's go. One, two cards left. Pretty good deck, too. Not surprised to see this in the finals. Alright, discarding Ancestral Vision. Alright, so I go to one, draw, play a Court Hussar. Alright, what are we hitting here? Put an Arcane Sanctum in hand. So, if I attack Liliana with these three, two get blocked. I gain a little bit of life, and then I get to put GT on Kaiga. I actually don't think this works. So 2 get blocked, then that goes to 7. I definitely would have to do that. I can't attack with Kakusho. Or can't attack with Kaiga because of Kakusho. And then I get to put GT on Kaiga, and then I can gain up to 5. Block Kakusho, go to 1. Yeah, alright, so. Not quite. Supreme Verdict probably seems okay here. Ooh, I can misdirect a Time Warp? Is that the only thing I can misdirect? It's mostly. What do I not like? I think I like most of the other cards, so. I need to take out Serum Visions because I sided an extra land. No, I just take out the Disenchant. This Disenchant was terrible. And Hikori. Yeah, I will not play Hikori.